Hello everybody, I am Mika from dmcx.com and today I am going to talk about Tadej Pogačar Konago V3 RS. The size, the fitting, the position, the geometry. So just before I proceed on, I just want to warn you, if you arrive to watch this video and you were expecting pictures or footage of the bike or the rider riding his bike, don't be disappointed by watching any further. There is none of those things. It is just a chat of me speaking to the camera and sharing the sketch of the geometry of the bike and the fitting of Tadej Pogačar bike. So, if it is for what you came for, you're welcome. Well, everybody is welcome. But it's just I don't want to waste people time if they were expecting something else. So that's why this is just a friendly warning before I proceed on. Right, Tadej Pogačar. It took me a long time to practice this name. This is a Slovenian pro rider. He's very young. He's actually, as I'm recording this video on August 2020, and his birthday is on September, and he was born in 1998, which means he will turn 22 in a couple of weeks. So he's very young, but very talented rider. He's not yet famous, I mean, not yet known by the main public, but you are gonna get his name soon all over the place on the internet. I'm gonna explain why. Right, so Tadej is racing for the team UAE since the year 2019. When he did join the team, he did participate for his first time to a Grand Tour, which was the Vuelta a España, and Tadej did win 3 stages, and he finished the Grand Tour on the podium. He finished 3rd of the Vuelta España. So this is somebody who have a very, very good future ahead of him as a pro rider. Because, as you know, it is a very tough race, and the people racing for the Vuelta or the Tour de France or the Giro are top gun people, really top gun. So, this is the introduction for Tadej. Tadej is actually 1 meter 67. Tadej is 1 meter 76 tall, and he weighs 66 kilograms at peak performance, which means when he's racing for a Grand Tour, he's at that weight. So he described himself as a climber, but not aggressive climber. I don't know what it means. We have to figure it out. But I assume he means he's very powerful type of climber. Not a fast climber, like as a reference, I would say Contador, for example. This is not this type. So my assuming is he's strong. So he's kind of like slow to go fast, but then he's going to be very fast in the climb. So this is probably what he's meaning when he's not an aggressive type of climber. As I said, he's very powerful actually. He did win the time trial national champion of Slovenia. He's of the year 2020, he's a national champion of Slovenian time trial. And he did win in front of another super famous Slovenian rider, yes, Primož Roglič. So this does mean a lot here, right? Now, let's focus on the bike of Tadej. Tadej is racing on a rim brake, yes, I said rim brake, not disc brake, on a rim brake Konago V3 RS. And the size of the bike is a Konago size 50. So, size 50 for Konago is different meaning than on other brand or you might have in your mind, like, wow, 50, size 50 for a guy 1 meter 76, it's not possible. Well, it is possible because I'm going to explain. Konago size 50 is a bit different than a size 50 centimeter frame on another brand. Basically, the size 50 Konago is measured from the center of the bottom bracket to the top of the seat tube. And the seat tube is actually short because the top tube is not horizontal, flat horizontal, as a zero, is actually going down as it goes towards the back of the bike. It is called sloping top tube. And this is where it's measured. It's instead of measuring on a horizontal to meet the top tube, it's actually the top tube is lower, and then this is at the top where it connects. This is how it is measured. So it is not a 50 centimeter frame as you would compare with, let's say, a Trek or a Cannondale or whatever the brand. It is a Colnago size 50. But if you look at the frame top tube length, it is 537 millimeters top tube length, which means it's approximately a 54 centimeter frame if you would compare with what most of people have in their mind when we refer to size of the frame. So 1.76 meter rider riding a 54 centimeter frame, it makes sense. He's a pro rider. As we know, they tend to get to a smaller frame size, but he's actually in a very good range of frame size with a 537 millimeters top tube length. So don't get upset with Colnago, like, why is it 50 centimeter? As I explained, it is a Colnago size 50. We can call it anything else we want. Right, so now keeping on the topic of the sizing of the bike. So the saddle height measured from the bottom bracket center, again, to the top of the saddle is 735 millimeters from the bottom bracket, center of the bottom bracket, to the top of the saddle. And the distance from the front of the saddle to the handlebar grip is 571 millimeters. Tadej is using a stem of 120 millimeters length with a 42 centimeters handlebar. It is one piece, actually, it is from Deda. It is a Alanella one piece aero combo. It's the stem and the bar are one piece. The stem is 120, as I said. The crankset lengths are 172.5 millimeters. Tadej is racing on the pedal from Look, the Look KO Blade Carbon. I think the whole team of UAE team is racing on Look pedals, actually. The whole that's the specific of Tadej. Actually, another specific of Tadej is the saddle. He's racing on the Prologo 0C3 Paz. That's the saddle he selected, and that's the specific for Tadej. After that, the remaining is if I'm going to talk about the frame while I am talking about the frame. The size 50 from Colnago have actually, it is also a new frame since last year, since 2019. It does replace a V2 Colnago, and the geometry has been rearranged, and also so now it becomes, as a current trend of the road bikes in the Proton, it is like a lightweight, aero bike, stiff, do-it-all kind of bike. So the team is racing with a rim brakes type. And as if you watch my other videos, I explain why some teams are on rim brakes and why some other teams are on disc brakes. Basically, to make it short, the teams racing to win a Grand Tour are racing with rim brakes. The other teams are basically racing maybe for a sprint win or a stage win, but except one, there is one team actually where the team leader has won the Giro and he's now racing on disc brake, and he's hoping to win again the Giro with the same with a disc brake setup. So it's going to be interesting if he does success. It will be the first bike, I mean the first team winning with disc brake, a Grand Tour. You get it right, yeah. Right, so sticking to the Colnago actually, the geometry has evolved between the V2 to the V3. This one has shorter chainstays, the angles has been a little bit refined, the head tube length is shorter, the fork is longer, and the BB drop is lower. So here again, this is marginal gain on the geometry to decrease the height of the rider. His position is, the center of gravity is lower, faster in the going down the hills. It's also faster on the flat because less drag because of the lower center of gravity, thanks to the lower BB, lower cockpit. So I try to explain everything in a short as short as possible. I try to make it the best as possible. I hope I do it good this time. The team is sponsored by Campagnolo, so the bikes are equipped with Campagnolo Super Record EPS 12 speed, so it means it's the shifting are electric shifting, and it is 12 speed group set. Most of the riders, including Tadej, is racing with a 53-39 crankset, and the cassette is depending of the stage, of course, but most of the time it is a 11-29 cassette. It is, and you can do big cross, you can do outer ring, and then the biggest cog on 29 at the back. So it is, for 12 speed, it is amazing. The wheels are from Campagnolo also, and the team is racing on Vittoria tires. So the Vittoria is a sponsor for the tires, the supplier, sorry. And the team is racing on tubeless and on tubular. It depends on the stage profile. If it is a mountain or like a very critical where the team has to win, like they are gonna go really, really fast, it will be on tubular, the one which is glued on the rim, tubular. And if it is a transition stage, they will be racing on tubeless, the one with no tube inside. It looks the same, but the performance are really different. The tubulars are more performant because they are glued to the rim with and there is no power loss. Well, and also the comfort of riding is just exceptional. So that's the details. I just want to add one thing. The team UAE, so including Tadej Pogacar, are racing with a special lubricant which is from Absolute Black, and this one is said to save 3 to 10 watts just by using that lubricant on that chain. So this is the only exotic thing on that bike, and Absolute Black is the official sponsor of the team UAE, so it means both parties believe in the superiority of using this lubricant. I don't know by myself, I never used it, but apparently it's very efficient, very, very good. Okay, I think I've been through everything. If you have any comment regarding to what I took today, please drop me a comment and I will make sure to reply to it. And if you enjoy what you are watching, please watch the other videos. See you there!